An interesting implementation question that I wanted to address in the course is the flickering issue. I mentioned this previously, but before we go deeper into what it is and how it can affect your experiments, let's talk a bit about what's under the hood of your website when you run an experiment. A website's code usually has two main parts, the head section and the body section. To simplify it a bit, the body section contains all the code for the things you see on a website, text, images, links, in other words, the content. The head section contains all the hidden code snippets, tracking codes, SEO metadata, hidden elements, and usually your A/B testing software's tracking code as well. When you open any website in your browser starts to render this code from top to bottom. Every element loads one after another and another. The elements of the head section first, then the elements of the body section. Now, it's important to know that Google Optimize, Optimizely, and most other website A/B testing tools by default work in a way that when a visitor gets assigned to group B and she visits your webpage, the software changes only those specific parts of your website to her that you have defined to be shown differently. So she will see the same webpage under the very same URL as group A visitors, only a few elements will be changed. And that's what your A/B testing JavaScript snippet takes care of. Which leads to an interesting question. What happens if your JavaScript snippet loads later than your website content? Of course, the user will see the original version A content first, and then it changes to version B. We call this flickering, and it's a terrible user experience. For this reason, you always want to put your A/B testing JavaScript snippet to the top of your website into the head section and within the head section as high as you can. But sometimes that's still not enough, unfortunately. The problem is that when you add a JavaScript snippet to the top of your website, it might slow down your page load time. You want to avoid that too. Fast websites are important for user experience and for SEO. That's why you want to set your A/B testing JavaScript snippet in a way that it loads asynchronously. Actually, you don't have to set anything. By default, your code will be set to this asynchronous mode. This means that by default, your JavaScript snippet will start to do its work when your website starts to render, but the other parts of your website won't wait for the A/B testing JavaScript snippet to actually being fully executed. They will just continue to render parallel with your script. That's perfect, because with that, your website page load time won't be affected, it will be just as fast as it was before, yet your A/B testing JavaScript will do its job in the background. There is one problem though. In some rare cases, when you create a very complex experiment with many changes and your users have a very bad internet connection, it can happen that because of this asynchronous loading, your website's content renders faster than your JavaScript. And that also leads to flickering. Your user will see your original version A first, then it changes to version B. Not a good user experience. How can you fix this? Firstly, not by setting your code from asynchronous to synchronous. That's a common mistake that I see, and you should not do that. Changing your JavaScript snippet to load from asynchronous to synchronous will slow down your website, and you don't want that, right? So keep the asynchronous JavaScript load. And at the same time, the best you can do is that you set up an extra anti-flickering snippet. This is another JavaScript snippet that basically detects those rare cases when your user is in group B, but the original version A content has already been rendered for her before the A/B testing JavaScript snippet fired. When this extra anti-flickering snippet recognizes this, it automatically excludes your user from your A/B test, the user won't see the variation, and this user's data won't be in your statistics either. This is the best solution that I've seen so far to prevent the flickering issue, and you can use that too. The actual implementation of the anti-flicker JavaScript snippets can be done by you or a developer at your company. Either way, find the links to the right tutorials below this video.